Ever notice how you'd come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with? That's me. Well,
I won't back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie. White on the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I would slap you.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Black at the Ace of Spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
United the racist with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We're also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. 888-77-JESSE. Express yourself. It's Open Line Friday. Let me go to the phones here. Oh, folks been waiting. I appreciate it. Let's go out to Memphis, Tennessee. Memphis, WMQM 1600. On the dial there, our 50,000 watts affiliates. Phil, good morning, yes. Sir. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Yes, Jesse, I think we all agree there was a time in American history when many whites, maybe a majority, I don't know, I didn't live then, certainly did have a prejudice against black people, and that's an unfortunate part of our history, starting with slavery and all of that.
But that's over now, Phil.
Right, that's over, but here's my question.
That's forgotten about.
Here's my point, my question. Most white people today that I know want black people to do well.
Yes.
They want them to succeed financially. They want them to have good houses. And if for no other reason, I mean, there are other reasons, but if no other reason, so they can be good citizens and
yes,
not
sir.
Be committing crime and that sort of thing. And I have businessmen, both white and black businessmen, tell me that it is getting increasingly difficult to find good workers, white or black, who will put in a good day's work, who will show up without being drunk and all of that. And I guess my question is, why is it that we see large numbers of young blacks and even increasing numbers of young whites who just don't want to work, they don't want to better themselves, they don't want to succeed in life, they just want to sort of hang around the lower edges of society and waste their lives
pot.
And the resources. Why is that? What's happened in America that has changed us like this? What's in your opinion, why are we this way?
It's a good question. Several reasons. Number one is the destruction of the family. Most of these black boys and girls are raised by a single mother or not raised at all by parents. And so when you destroy the family, you destroy the souls of these young people. And then they have gone out into the world and they have been told that America is a racist society. White people are trying to hold you back. You can't make it. And so they hate their fathers and mothers for not being there for them. But that hate is turned on white people because they listen to people like Barack Obama and others who say, well, if I had a son, he'd look like Trayvon Martin. And so they're angry and they're going after white folks. And white people are afraid. So that's bringing the worst out of these folks. And then they're told, well, so, you know, racism is a problem. The government will take care of you. Don't worry. And so they're just sitting back, smoking pot, and getting a free affirmative action, welfare checks, or whatever it is that they want. They do not have to earn their way, and they have not been taught how to work hard and earn their way. And that's not going to change, Phil, until we can rebuild families. We got to get men to turn back to God and go into their family, go marry these women and children and guide them, protect them spiritually, and take care of them financially, then it would start to change.
Well, do you think the politicians, both white and black, do not see this as a problem, the loss of the bail in the home, or do not care? Or
do
what?
Not. They want it that way because you can't control a moral people. You have to demoralize them in order to control them. And the government love power. They love positions. And they know that if the people were to wake up, then they wouldn't be in office as long as they're there. But if they could keep them asleep by demoralizing them and giving them free stuff, free Obama phones and things like that, then they can stay in office. They don't care about the people. The government has never cared about the people. It is not the responsibility of the government to care about people. It's we the people, not we the government.
You're right. I just wish more people could wake up. I mean, our country's going down the tubes. I mean, people don't see it.
They do see it. The good folks see it, and they feel helpless to it. They don't know what to do to change it because it's so far gone. And then the immoral people don't care because they don't care what's going on. They feel as though they have nothing to lose. They're getting everything free anyway, so they really
right.
don't care. Phil, you're a white guy, right? You sound
right.
white. Is this your first time calling the show?
I've called once several years ago, but I hadn't called in several years.
Well, good to hear from you again. Let me ask, most white people are afraid to stand up to black people and call out black racism for fear of being called racist. Are you afraid to tell black people the truth for fear of being called racist?
Well, it's not so much that fear as I'm afraid of getting shot by some of them. You know what I'm saying? That's my biggest. I don't have anything. My biggest fear against black people is they're going to shoot me.
I understand that.
I live in Memphis where there is a lot of crime, and most of it is not black on white. I know that. I mean, it's black on black.
Yes.
By far.
Yes.
But you know, we just want people to love each other and to get along and quit committing crime. I mean, that's most of the white people I know, the only thing they don't like about black people is there's an increase in crime when more of them are around. I mean, as far as the color of the skin, they've gotten over that a long time ago.
Yes.
I think about when a house goes up for sale next door to me. Man, I'd give anything to have a black guy like you move in next door than some white trash. You know what I mean? It's not the color of the skin. It's how they act. Like
it's
Martin Luther King used to talk about, the content of their character. That's all
right.
We're looking for.
Well, you know, the unfortunate thing, not all blacks, of course, not all, but most of the black people in Memphis, Tennessee, they don't know. They have not realized that the civil rights movement is over, and they have not... they don't know that they are free. They
right.
still think that there is a race war going on from whites to blacks. And they don't know that they're free. They don't know that the civil rights movement is over. They may not even know that Martin Luther King Jr. is dead.
That's true.
Because they don't pay attention. They do not read for themselves. They don't look outside of their blackness to really see what's going on in the world. And that's why they are in Memphis, Tennessee, the crime is out of control. There are black on black crime,
mm-hmm.
and the dependency on government support and the out of wedlock birth is
right.
beyond my imagination.
Oh yeah. Well, see, the neighborhood I live in is one third white, one third black, one third Hispanic. So I'm not running away from people of color because of the color of their skin.
Right.
I just want people to live decently and to quit committing crime, and let's all live together and have a good neighborhood and all that. But
well,
you know, it just seems like that's not possible anymore.
Well, I do understand why you would be concerned about, you know, them hurting you, because they're going around the country knocking out white people and killing them in some cases. They're robbing them, and just horrible things happening to whites from blacks. And that's because black people are very angry, not all
right.
the most. They've been set up to be angry, and they don't realize it. But I still, be careful, but I urge you to tell black people the truth, because they're not getting it in their churches. They're not getting it in their homes. They're not getting the truth in the schools. So, and their politicians are not going to tell them the truth. They don't want black folks to wake up. So it's been put up on good men and women like you to tell black people the truth and hope that some of them will wake up.
I hear you, Bill. I appreciate what you're doing, because you've got a good heart.
Thank you, my friend. God bless you, and thanks
bless
for
you.
Your call.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. 888-77-JESSE. We're coming back to the phones after this break.